Hello guys, my name is Ian Rogers from Hispania, Kenya. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Today content, I'm going to show you how the meat, beef meat fried stew is being prepared. So with me here, I'm from the market. I was going there. I came with some items that I'm going to use today. Now I think for those people who are watching over me, they will enjoy the meal which I'm going to prepare it. And make sure if you didn't subscribe to any of my content which I make in the previous, comment, share and view. So now I'm at home. I've reached already from the market. Now I want to prepare that meal of today. Before that, let me show you this is my working place where I will make that food of today. With me here, I've already put some items here. I used two sufurias. That one for catching sufuria. A basin of mine. A place where I'm going to cut my beef. Okay, these are the things which I'm going to prepare. I've bought some ingredient here with me, some tomato. These are tomato. This tomato I've bought for 50 bob. No, not 50, 100 bob of Kenyan shillings. As you can see, these are the tomato. Also, dania here, 10 bob, hoho for 20, and beef. This is my beef which I bought in the butchery. And also, I have here onions which I've came with. So, the first thing I'm going to cut is meat of mine. I'm going to cut so that I can put for frying, then I make a stew. Okay, before I continue cutting this beef of mine, let me go and light my jiko so that by the time it's lighting, then I will come back to finish cutting my beef. Then the okay, here is my jiko with me, and then put some charcoal here. Here's my jiko, put in the charcoal. Filling my jiko. The next step, I'm going to light my jiko. Let me have a seat here.
I want to bring fire.
Okay, after filling my jiko with the charcoal, let me go and search for some small firewood outside here so that my jiko to be heated. Okay.
Okay. Here with me I have my
firewood. This firewood is going to be used for lightening that jiko of mine. Although I'm sick, but we'll try to do that food of mine. Remember, this food I'm going to make, the beef stew, is going to be eaten with the ugali. Also, you can eat with
spaghetti or rice or chapati, but for today I'm going to use with the ugali. Okay, I think these sticks are enough. This one, after cutting my after putting here, now I'm going to light. Okay, you light that like that using a matchbox. I think those people are in broad countries. I think they don't have this matchbox, but here with me is a African matchbox. So after by the time my jiko is light, and let me go ahead and wash my hands, because I've got charcoal, meaning that my hands are dirty. Let me wash my hands by this bucket of mine here. I pour some water, then I wash it by using manila. And then I put some water, then I wash my hand like that. I wash. That after washing up my hands, though, the next step I'm going to show you now how I'm going to cut my beef. Okay. After reaching here, next step I'm going to cut this meat into small pieces like that. Remember, this food of mine is going to be eaten with 6 people. This is my beef. This is a cow beef. Cow. After cutting my beef, then I put aside, then I pour some water in my ingredients. These are dania. I remove this part, edible part, like that. Put aside there.
chop, chop. The side like that. Then I take my second ingredient, onion. I remove this part, the top part. Put aside there. These two of mine onions are enough for that meat. The rest I will be using tomorrow. Also, need to remove this part of mine. This is how it look like. Put aside. Then let me look for a tomato like these ones. These ones will make a stew, which I'm going to put my beef. Then let me go ahead and bring some water in my basin, which I'm using here, so that I can wash my ingredients. I rinse my basin, then I pour. After pouring some water in my basin, then the next step I'm going to take my jiko. I put here where there is a shade, then I put these stands. That I'm going to put my sufuria on top here and my beef, so that can be roasted for the first time. Thereafter, I will put aside, then I will roast my stew. Then I will mix up those stew and roasted meat so that can be look delicious and so very good to be eaten with the ugali. So let me go ahead and take my sufuria. I have to put sufuria here. I'm going to use this one. After taking this one, then I'm going to put this meat of yours here inside there. Put inside like that. Then I put on my jiko. Like that. Then I put a little amount of water inside here. Like that. Okay, after putting some water in my sufuria, which have a beef, then I go ahead and wash my ingredient here. Tomato, which I've already prepared for it, for that meal of today. Then I wash them thoroughly. After washing them, then okay, after putting here my ingredient in clean water, then I'm going to put aside this edible part aside, so that my working place to be clean and neat, so that people when they eat my food they can take it nice, make sure the place is clean. Then I put my tomato, which I will be used tomorrow. Aside, there's my salt. After putting aside, then I'm going now to cut wood. I'm going now to grater my. This is a grater, which I'm going to use grittering my tomato. I wash it like that. Then I use this part, like that. that, I put this edible part, then I put aside. Then I take another one. This grater, actually, it helps those people like me who I'm sick, not to stress myself by cutting or by chopping with a knife, meaning that the grater actually it gives me an easy time. So today, okay, after preparing my tomato with the grater, then the next step I'm going to cut my hojas into small pieces. I chop like that. Chop like that. Cutting like that, then I take my dania also. Then also I cut them. Then I divide them. First one, the next one, dania with me here. Lastly, onions. That after cutting like that, my then I put aside, then I cover them. Let me cover them. Then I want to go in my garden, shamba, to remove some scales. Okay, my kales with my basin. Okay, I'm going to throw my edible parts in my garden. As you can see here, my garden has bananas. Have bananas of mine here. We have some peppers here with me. These are peppers. Which make these are appetizing. This is my garden. Wow. Let me throw like that so that I can bring a fertility. Let me go ahead and look for a skuma. Kelp. Mawiki, kelp. These are my bananas. Okay. Let me go ahead and start. This is my banana, although it has not, it has reached this maturity. It's ready now. You can eat, you can cook it, then you can eat with a strong tea or coffee. Okay, I'm going to remove some one part of kuma wiki like that. Plucking this, I'm plucking out this by sukuma wiki garden. I'm going to cook so that it can be eaten with the meat, which I'm beef meat, which I'm going to prepare it. That is my garden. Wow. Kels. Also, we have here pigweed. This also is being, you can eat this with the beef, but today I'm going to use kelp. Also have pumpkin leaves, also used by beef or rice or anything, meaning that I have, these are my garden, this garden of mine, it has almost several types of vegetable. That I think now these scales of mine are enough for today. Yeah. This is what I'm going to use when eating with that beef of mine. So let me go ahead and wash these scales of mine. Okay, let me go ahead and wash these scales of mine so that I can cut them into small pieces so that I can boil it. And then put in my stew of meat, beef meat, and then I eat. This is my area, that is my dustbin where I do throw or put my dust there. This is my area where I'm coming from. Remember, I'm talking from Kenya, being found in Africa. Thank you very much. But consider subscribing to those who have not subscribed to me.
Then I wash them, then I cut them into small, small pieces. Okay, I'm going to remove this part which is not edible. Then I start chopping to small pieces like that. After that, then I pour my water, that, then I put my kettles here in my basin. Make sure your working place is so clean like this. After that, then I put these kettles of mine, then I remove these dirty things, then I put aside like that, then I do like that. Okay, so the next thing then I'm going to look whether my beef is ready for burning with the cooking oil. I open my lid. Uh-huh. After that, meaning that they are ready to be burned, meaning I'm going to remove that heated water. I put in a cup or in a cup or in a plate like this. Let me bring my cut. Uh-huh. Before. After that, after removing my meat, beef meat, then I'm going to put some cooking oil here. That. Like that. Then close it tightly. This is the ufuta. This is good for use for beef and vegetable cooking oil. Then you leave it for a moment to be burn that cooking oil. Then take a cooking stick. Is a cooking stick?
check my kamatas. Here I burn them with the cooking oil first. Let me burn them thoroughly. After that, I'm going to put some sugar, salt, I'm going to put some salt, then you can take this out of mine. Yeah. Done. My cameraman can zoom it so that you can see how it's being burned. That beef of mine, that after burning this meat for 5 minutes like that, then the next thing I'm going to remove this meat of mine, beef meat. Then I put aside in a clean plate of this one. I put here for the deco. After that, then now I'm going to put my put aside. Then I check. My ingredient now. These are my ingredients now. Let me put, starting with onions of mine. I stir up my onions like that. Burn them, I burn them thoroughly. Then next thing, I'm going to put my hohos inside. Like that, those onions of mine, like that. That, then I put hohos. Meaning I'm going to make a stew. Okay. Okay, I'm going to pick my tomato, which I have already prepared. The finger, meaning I'm doing good things, doing smart. So let me put this one. Here's the third ingredient, dania. Make sure all ingredients have entered in your sphere, heated sphere. Burn them, those ingredients, and you still mix your mess like that. So that you can add a little amount of okay, I'm going to pour my tomato. That. Then I put aside, then I make it that. Then you leave that stew of yours to be burned like 2 to 3 minutes. Then after that, I'm going to put my beef on that stew. Okay, after my stew is ready, then I'm going to put my beef like that. As you can see, it looks amazing food.
Wow. You can eat this stew of mine of meat with the rice or chapati. Wow, 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 wow. So I think those people who are watching over me, doing my content of the day, they are stammering their matters, saliva. Hey! Oh no! Okay. After that, then you. You pour some soup inside. Like that. That, then you can test if the salt has, it has a taste inside your soup. Let me add some. Okay, let me put a lid on top of my sphere so that it can be burnt. After that, I'm going to prepare. By the time my beef meat is being burned there, I'm going to prepare the sukuma kales of mine. I'm going to prepare with the onion only. Then let me wash and open up that gas of mine. Then I put a sphere like that. I take this oil. I put inside like that. Enough. Then I close it tightly. Then I take my onion, then I remove it thoroughly like that, like that. After removing like that, I'm going to cut like that. Check like that and put there. After that, let me go and check the cooking stick very fast. Then I tear up my onion like that. Then I'm going to take my kales. Then I'm going to put inside my onion. There. I'm going to put small. Then I take thank you.
simmer is almost to be ready, because here my bridget kales is ready. Now I'm going to put in my hot pots. That take my beef stew, then I pour. Wow. Like that. After finishing that point, I'm going to open my lid, which I put in my water, which I'm going to cook ugali. When I put aside, then I'm going to put inside the flour, cooking flour, maize cooking flour, inside my water. Then start cook my food like that. So my ugali is ready. I'm going to remove my ugali so that I can get that lunch of mine. Let me go ahead and take. This is how my souffle it look like, and this is my ugali. And now I'm going to wash my hand here so that I can serve my food. The rest, for those who are not here, because I said earlier that this food is belong to 6 people, they'll come and serve themselves. So let me go ahead and serve myself here, because I'm too hungry. Very hungry, three hungry. Okay. What? My serving spoon, where is it? That is the kales. This meat now. Actually, it smells nice. Put my stew here. Enough. Let me leave for those people who are not here. Soup. Then
take a knife. Now I'm cutting. There's enough meat. We'll put here. The rest will cut for themselves. Yeah, this is now my food. Let me have a seat so that I can. Before that, let me pray. Oh God, bless this food before I take it through this and pray. Amen. Father, Son, and Spirit, amen. Thank you very much. Remember, for those who are watching over me, subscribe to my video channel. Big man, Rogers, I am. Thank you very much.
Wow. Good.
Bye-bye.